stole my wife, you horse thief.
But don't bring her back anymore.
I started the record company because Dizzy and I, well, I'll tell you what it was. Dizzy had been with RCA Victor and a lot of small labels. Then he went to Capitol Records, which became, you know, was a big company. And they made him do a song which somebody wrote called "You Stole My Wife, You Horse Thief, You."
You stole my wife, you horse thief.
The wife that I used to adore.
You stole my wife, you horse thief.
But don't bring her back anymore.
When Dizzy and I talked about that, we said, listen, this is ridiculous. So we started the Dee Gee Records to produce our own stuff. That was how it all started. You stole my wife, you whore thief, you. On Capitol Records. But, you know, it was an insult. Without a doubt, you know. So we said, later. And that was how Dee Gee Records started. My mother had insisted that I go to the Detroit Symphony, which was at Orchestra Hall. Every Saturday they had young people's concerts, and the city provided buses to take children from the schools who wanted to attend. And I was, you know, one of the children that did attend, and that's where my influence had started in being interested in the symphony. What happened was I listened to some jazz music, which was by Cab Calloway. And this was on a label that was part of Columbia Records, called Vocalion, V-O-C-A-L, Vocalion, C-A-L-I-O-N. And the one particular thing that interested me was they were 78s, so they were no more than, say, 3 minutes or so on the side. And the one that interested me was called Tarzan of Harlem. So I enjoyed listening to the band, and they were playing, and then had a trumpet solo in this big band, and the guys in the band after the trumpet solo said, "He's Diz the Wiz, a real horn tutor." And it was fascinating because nobody had ever heard anybody play that way. And that's what did it to me, too. He just, whatever he had to say fell into my mind and ears. That was it. I probably was about, I don't know, 10 or 11 years old or something like that. And I couldn't believe what I was hearing because I'd had a classical background. And I understood that. But it was the way he played that nobody else had ever played. Of course, now, you know, it's part and parcel for many people in the jazz field. So I followed him. We were a very unique composite because he was black and I was white. at that time, people didn't have those identity factors. The biggest thing going, well, was somebody like Joe Louis. And of course, there was people before that, you know, but the fact that there was a combination like himself and I was unique. I remember I went to see him. He was leading a band for Billy Eckstein. Charlie Parker was in the band. Dizzy. I went backstage and wanted to meet him. So the stage manager said, well, wait here, which was at the backstage door, and he'll be coming out. So he came out with his wife after the performance. And at this time, there was a gasoline strike in Detroit. Couldn't get gas. It was during the war when you had stamps that told you it was A or whatever, you know, how much gas you would get when you filled up. So I said, well, I'd like to, you know, take you and your wife to your hotel. Well, the hotel was only a block away. It was the Gotham Hotel, which was a black hotel about on Brush and Orchestra Place, as I recall. And that's how we met. Dee Gee Records. That's what it stood for. D-E-E-G-E-E. And our first recording, I remember, had John Coltrane and Kenny Burrell, became a well-known guitar player, amongst others, and that started us out. That was it.
Now Dizzy is my name.
You stole my wife, you horse.
The wife that I used to adore.
You stole my wife, you horse.
Don't bring her back. I don't want her back. Please don't bring her back anymore.